How blood flows in the vessels? What is laminar blood flow? And when it becomes turbulent? We will answer all these questions in this video. Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. This is a schematic diagram of the circulatory system. Here, the blood flow is a quantity of blood that passes a given point in the circulation in unit time. It is usually expressed as milliliters per minute. For example, renal blood flow is about 1000 ml per minute. In adult person, total blood flowing through the entire systemic circulation is about 5000 ml per minute under resting conditions. This total blood flow is also called cardiac output. Now let's talk about the nature of the blood flow. Blood flow can be laminar or turbulent. Laminar blood flow occurs when blood flows at a steady rate through a long and smooth blood vessel. In this, blood flows in streamlines. Because of cohesive forces between the inner surface of the vessel wall and the blood, the layer of blood close to the wall is almost stagnant. The next concentric cylinder layer slips over this outer layer of the blood, so it moves faster than the first layer. The third layer slips over the second one, so its velocity is even higher than the second one. Thus, velocity increases from the wall to the center of the blood vessel. Because of this, the resulting velocity profile is a bullet-like parabola with the maximum velocity at the center. So, this is a nice and tidy laminar blood flow. Now, let's talk about turbulent blood flow. Blood flow becomes turbulent in case of very high blood flow, obstruction in a vessel, when the blood makes a sharp turn, or flows over a rough surface. In turbulent flow, the blood flows in all directions, usually forming whirls and continuously mixing within the vessel. Turbulence increases resistance to the blood flow. So this was turbulent blood flow. Now, we can predict if blood flow would be laminar or turbulent from a parameter called Reynolds number. It's a dimensionless parameter and it's equal to dV rho divided by eta. Here, d is diameter of blood vessel, v is velocity of the blood, rho is density, and eta is the viscosity of the blood. The higher the Reynolds number, the more the chance of turbulent flow. Below 2000, the flow is usually laminar, and above 3000, it's mostly turbulent. From the equation, we can see that higher velocity of the blood flow and larger diameter of blood vessel tends to increase Reynolds number and thereby cause turbulence. Whereas viscosity of the blood tends to decrease Reynolds number and thereby tends to maintain laminar blood flow. This explains type of blood flow in different conditions. For example, in small vessels, flow is almost always laminar due to smaller diameter. In large arteries, some turbulence occurs at the branches. High cardiac output increases blood velocity, which tends to cause turbulence. In proximal portion of the aorta and pulmonary artery, large vessel diameter as well as high blood velocity both contribute to the turbulence. In pathological conditions like arterial stenosis, turbulence occurs due to a local increase in velocity. And this brings us to another clinical significance. Laminar flow is silent, whereas turbulent flow can be auscultated as murmurs. For example, Korotkov sounds during measuring blood pressure, and murmurs in vessel stenosis, shunts, and cardiac valvular lesions are produced by turbulent blood flow. Very intense turbulence can even be felt by touch as thrills. This was all about the blood flow. Let's have a quick summary. Blood flow is a quantity of blood that passes a given point in the circulation in unit time. Laminar blood flow is seen when blood flows at a steady rate through a long and smooth blood vessel. Here, velocity increases as we go from vessel wall to the center. Turbulent flow occurs in case of very high blood flow, obstruction in a vessel, sharp turn, and rough surface. Reynolds number is a measure of tendency of turbulence to occur. Large diameter of large vessels and high velocity in high cardiac output conditions tend to cause turbulence, whereas viscosity of the blood tends to prevent it. Murmurs produced by turbulence are important in measuring blood pressure and in diagnosis of some conditions like vessel stenosis, shunts, and cardiac valvular lesions. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.